the intro.
When your day is long, and the night is yours alone, and you're sure you've had enough of this life.
Well, I just got the sadness out of the way before the intro right there. Yes, our Kansas City Chiefs fell to the Detroit Lions 21-20. And it's a sad Friday. It's raining here in Orlando, Florida, where I'm at. So God has heard my tears. And the tears are raining down for me. But there is silver lining, folks. It is only week one. So everyone who has the concerns about the Chiefs and what everything I'm about to get into, because there is going to be a rant in this episode. I have a lot to say. And the name Kadarius Toney will be mentioned a lot. With that being said, welcome in everybody to another episode of the TPT Podcast. I'm your host, Jaden Lawler. Going over today, it's going to be the Detroit Lions versus the Kansas City Chiefs and what kind of transpired in this game as not a great start to the season for the Chiefs. But when you have a guy like Travis Kelce out and a guy like Chris Jones out, these are going to be the type of things that are expected. The number one thing to start out the show I did not like to see was how poor, how piss-ass poor. I mean, it's already the madness has already started to build up in me. I tried to come in today with a positive attitude, but how piss poor our receivers were. And for all the uneducated people that this may make the way to, the people that are saying this was on Patrick Mahomes, Oh, Patrick Mahomes doesn't look like him. Oh, maybe he's not in the groove. Super Bowl slip. Blah, de, blah, de, blah, de, blah. Patrick Mahomes was fine. Yeah, Patrick Mahomes is leading the league in interceptions. Huh? Oh, I see them all. I see all the tweets and comments. I see them all. Kadarius Toney is the next thing I want to talk about. Patrick Mahomes looked fine. We got that out of the way. And then we're going to talk about the receivers. Kadarius Toney, whatever you want to call him. Take the children out of the room for a second. What the flying hell was that? What was that? That was the worst game as a receiver I have seen in the Andy Reid era. Worst. You can maybe put one in the comment section if you want, folks. That is the worst damn performance I've seen as a wide receiver in the Andy Reid era. Can't catch. For those of you who are listening to this on audio, it's me acting like Kadarius Toney, the ball slipping through his damn hands. So if you might want to go right now, if you're listening to it on Spotify, go check it out on YouTube, because I'm pretty animated right now. What scares me is we have a 34-year-old tight end. And again, the Chiefs will be fine this year. I'm going to get to that more later. But I got to go. I got to get this out of my system. I got it. Travis Kelce is 33, 34 years old. And again, he has not shown any signs of slowing down. He's still that guy. But we can't rely on him every damn game. And I do not think Kadarius Toney's still a good player. I do not think this is going to be an occurring thing with the Chiefs. But if it is, they're in trouble. Chiefs are in trouble. I think, again, first game, Chiefs coming in. Yes, you had Sky Moore dropping balls. Richie James dropped the ball. Blake Bell dropped the ball. I think Noah Gray dropped the ball. You had every receiver out there dropping passes. Like, it was just too hot. Oh, hot potato. You know the song, Drop It Like It's Hot? That was this game. That was his game. Hot potato, hot potato. That's what Tony was saying. If you're not ready to play, get your ass off the field. Get your ass off the field. And I love Andy Reid because he always sticks guys back out there because he's like, oh, they messed up, but they're going to go out there. And they're going to make a big play. And we saw that with Sky Moore in the Super Bowl. And we saw it with Sky Moore in the AFC Championship. We saw it with Kadarius Toney. And we've seen it with guys in the past where they'll make a mistake and they come right back and they make a huge play. But this time, Andy Reid, you were wrong. You're wrong. You should have put Justin Reid in more. You should have put other guys. You should have targeted MVS more. But instead, you stuck with Toney, who absolutely screwed us in the ass. 100%. This is not a friends and family episode, guys. I am truly pissed at just – in week one, I'm going to get to the positives, I promise. But in week one, the pure stupidity from players and just offensive line there at the end. I thought the tackles did a pretty good job during the course of the game. Aiden Hutchinson is for real. Everyone's saying that Donovan Smith and Juwan Taylor look bad. First game, yeah, they had some bad snaps. I'm not going to lie. But first game, overall, thought they were fine. But when you have a whammy of Kadarius Toney, whoops, not catching the ball, and then Juwan Taylor or maybe Donovan Smith get the false start, it felt like Matt Castle was still out there, and this was 2012. And I know we have such a high standard for the Chiefs, and when we lose a game, it's like the world is ending. And I truly don't want to have that type of vibe I'm getting right now. I'm just so upset because everyone in the media really thinks the Detroit Lions are this team that is a Super Bowl contender and can win 12 games and all this. They're not. They're a 9-8 team, maybe a 10-win team. But losing 21-20 to a team we were clearly better than, the guys just made some plays. And on the defense side of the ball, yeah, we didn't have Chris Jones. If Chris Jones is in that game, we win that game by 10 points. Chris Jones gets home a couple times. Shout out to George Karloftis. I thought he got back there a lot. He had two or three batted passes. He got back there a lot. I think George Karloftis did a very good job. I thought Bolden did a very good job. But Trent McDuffie was probably the player of the game. Obviously, there's Mahomes and Mahomes. But Trent McDuffie was probably the player of the game. I thought he played great. I thought Trent McDuffie played great. I really did. He had some good tackles. He got beat a couple times. That's National Football League. You're going to get beat a couple times. I thought the defense played well. They gave up 14 points. The defense gave up 14 points, and Kadarius Toney had a pick six that went the other way. I was on him. That was on him. I mean, we almost essentially lost the game because of Kadarius Toney. I'm not going to blame all of it on him, but essentially lost the game because of Kadarius Toney. Kudos to the Lions. This one hurts, but there is some positive to it. Rashee Rice had a hell of a game. Hell of a game. I think he had three or four catches, had a touchdown. And it was very rare to see that he had one of the highest snap counts as a receiver in an Andy Reid-type offense. In an Andy Reid-type offense, he had one of the higher snap counts. And I thought he looked pretty good. I thought he looked good. I will say this, though, the run game, on a negative note again, run game didn't. Patrick Mahomes had 47 yards. He led the team in rushing. Run game did not look good. And again, it's the first game. I'm not just going to be Chicken Little and saying the sky is falling. I think the Chiefs will be fine. I will personally be at this Jacksonville Jaguars game in Jacksonville. So if they lose when I'm at the game, I'm going to be pissed. And here's the thing. If they go out and they play this Jacksonville team, who I think is on the up and coming, and I think is a very good team, but if they go out and they lay another goose egg versus Jacksonville, Travis Kelce looks a step slow coming back. The wide receiver core looks bad, then we can start being concerned. But this is a fringy AFC championship team. Yeah, they can get to the playoffs. They can even maybe win a wild card game. But this is a wild card team. If they go up against Jacksonville and look bad in back-to-back weeks, they can't. They can't go to Jacksonville and look bad in back-to-back weeks. But there was some positives. Rice looked good as a rookie. I think even Ross, when he was in there, I thought they should have used him more. With Travis Kelce back, there'll be a little bit more familiarity. They'll be out there. I think they're gonna practice running the ball a little bit more this week. They'll be a little bit better running the ball next week. And again, Detroit, they're a good team. They're not great. I'm not gonna sit here and say they're a great team, but they're a good team. They got some playmakers. I still think the Vikings are a team to be reckoned with in that division. I'm not 100% sold on the Lions. I'm not. But then the Chiefs should have won that game. It was embarrassing going out there. You have the Nona Hunt game. You have the championship banners coming down, and they lay a goose egg. They came in there and got punched in the mouth. And they have to respond. They have to respond in a big time way. Big time way versus Jacksonville. I mean, I think they need to put up 30 to 40 points to show the league again. Hey, you may also lose to Detroit, but guess what? We're still the Kansas City mother freaking Chiefs. That's what they got to do. And that starts with being able to run the ball more and wide receivers stepping up and coaching being better. Let me get into this real quick. The Blake Bell QB sneaks or these little jet sweeps, those are fine every now and then. When you're running them two or three times a game and getting cute in the red zone, I ended up scoring on that drive, but getting cute in the red zone. Nothing more chaps my ass than Andy Reid getting cute in the red zone. Run it. Run it down their throat. I know you were running the ball, but line up. Say you have a good offensive line. You know you have a good offensive line. And just run it. It's third and one. But when you do this stupid crap and you have to end up punting the ball because you can't pick up a yard, it's stupidity. I'm sick of this little Blake Bell crap under center. All that I am. I'm done with it. I'm done with it. I am. Stop being cute in the red zone. That's one of my biggest second point I have here is stop getting cute in the red zone. And really, my third point, one of my third and final points, is they do need Justin. Excuse me, they do need Chris Jones. Justin Reed is what I was gonna say. Justin Reed, I think, played terrible. He had a big crucial stop on fourth down. But they need Chris Jones. They absolutely need Chris Jones in this season. And I see a lot of people saying, okay, well, maybe they go get Mike Evans, they trade a third something. I don't see them getting a guy like Mike Evans. Do they make a trade? Probably. I don't see them getting Mike Evans. I think if they do, it'll be at the deadline. They're not going to do anything in the first couple of weeks, and they'll say, shut up really bad. They want to make a desperation. But they got a tough couple games coming up, and they need to kind of get this ugliness out of the way, this ugly game out of the way. Going to Jacksonville next week, at least for me, I'm going to be at the game. Do it for me. They need to get out of the way. They need Chris Jones back. They need to get this deal done so he can come back. Play versus Jacksonville. I did not like that he was in the box with his two soprano looking agents. Did not like that at all. He gets to sit comfy, cozy in the box, and while his teammates are out there busting their ass trying to get it done, and he's out there comfy, cozy in the box. I didn't like that at all. I didn't like that at all. Hated it. Hated it. He probably did make some more money in last night's game because if he was in that game, the Kansas City Chiefs would have won by 10 points. Kelce's in that game, the Chiefs would have won by 10 points. And the Chiefs are missing Chris Jones, Charles Amenhue, and Travis Kelce. But I'm not making any excuses. The Kansas City Chiefs should have absolutely won that game. And it starts with running the ball, wide receivers, young wide receivers finding their role and stepping up. And three, stop being cute with it. Those are my three things the Kansas City Chiefs need to change going into this game versus the Jacksonville Jaguars. And again, like I want to say, lastly, Patrick Mahomes is fine. I think the Kansas City Chiefs are going to be fine. I really do. I'm not worried about the Chiefs being an old Super Bowl slump. I'm not worried about the Kansas City Chiefs, being a 10 or 9-1 team or anything like that. Yeah, they got some guys on this. They're going to get these guys back, and the Kansas City Chiefs will be absolutely okay. They're going to be one of the best teams in the NFL. They're going to have that first seed. And once the Chiefs start getting on a roll, everything's going to be kumbaya. But I will tell you this, Chiefs fans, They're going to lose some games. They're going to. That's the name of the game. They're going to lose some games, and it sucks. But guess what? You're still going to be a 12 to 13 win team this season. 14. If you don't lose the stupid teams, you're going to go into every game almost favored, probably besides the Bills or Bengals, if that. You have your toughest, the rest of your games that are tough, you have at home besides the Jets and the Dolphins. The rest of your tough games are at home. The Kansas City Chiefs will absolutely be okay. Say it with me, folks. Okay. They'll be just fine. Let me know what you guys think of this last game, some of the things we need to work on. Please comment below. Make sure you guys follow us on all social media at TPT Podcast and at Jaden's_jerseys. You guys can find great jerseys like this, great hats like this over at Jaden's Jerseys. So make sure you guys go check that out. Make sure you follow us on Instagram for the latest news and updates. I post a lot over there. So we will see you guys next time on the TPT Podcast.